Davis. Long ball forward by him. And he could be underneath it. It's a bit of an obvious push in the back there by Adam Brazil. So a free kick. James Norwood looks as if he might fancy it. Doug Dale being spoken to by the referee. Not too sure it was more about what he said after the foul had been given rather than the actual foul itself, but anyway. No, he's still down. He's struggling with it, isn't he? Anyway, we'll see after this free kick. Norwood and Jennings over the ball. Jennings steps over the ball now. What can James Norwood do? Looking for the corner. He does it in. There's a decent save, but Stephen Jennings puts him in the rebound. And the Tranmere captain has his first goal of the season. James Norwood with a free kick, saved by putting it down towards his right hand side. And Stephen Jennings is a player following it up to turn the ball into the roof of the net. And we've had 24 minutes here, and it's Tranmere Rovers 1, Eastleigh 0. Showing too much in open play, but he's pulled down the touchlines of a bird again. Thorne's gone across with him, gets it back to Howell's, got a decent left foot on him. Long cross comes in through Tranmere, plays for the same ball. That's a real opportunity. It's an equaliser turned in from nowhere. That was all about three defenders going for the same ball. Adam Dugdale was there to pick up the loose one and drills it past Scott Davis. And half an hour gone, it's Tranmere 1, Eastleigh 1. Eastleigh with an equaliser here. A long ball forward by Howells and three Tranmere defenders, I'm afraid, all went for the same ball. None of them got a clean header. It fell for Adam Dugdale and he was able to pick his spot. And it's Tranmere 1, Eastleigh 1. Davis comes to the edge of his penalty area. Long ball forward, it's bounced beyond them. And the outside the box here is Connor Jennings. He goes on and in the end it's gone behind for a corner. Almost got some knock on, didn't he? So we're going to join the action very shortly. Anyway, it's a corner left hand side. Steve Jennings will take it. 17 minutes left here. 4-1 Eastleigh 1. James with the corner. Trying to get there. Gets the defender's head. Nicole will retrieve it. On the snare side. Pulls across in again. Hughes arriving. Maynard is underneath him. On the ball, Luke Coulson didn't, and Maynard went over the top of him, and that's a Tranmere penalty.
It's a penalty all day, all week, all year. As you said, the difference there was that Maynard, he kept his eye on the ball, he went for the ball, and the player has just gone underneath and taken him completely out. That's going to be one of the easiest ones we've ever been able to
do. Coulson on Maynard then gives the penalty away. James Norwood, Beddington top end. So they get an opportunity to put Tranmere in front. Norwood against Huddett. Real opportunity for Rovers to go back in front here. James Norwood just waiting for the referee to tell him he can take it. Norwood comes forward now. James Norwood hits the crossbow and it comes out. Still inside the penalty area. He struck it with power and pace, but it hit the underside of the bar, bounced down, not behind the line, and that opportunity is gone, and now Eastleigh will power forward themselves. Eastleigh, fourth play towards the left-hand side. Gets away on this near side. Put in there by Harris, that's going to be a Tranmere free kick. Ball rolled, forward by Huddett, one ball forward by him, away by McNulty. Dugdale heads the ball forward again, McNulty's underneath it, headed up towards half, again, heading forward again, ball by Jennings, he's onside, it's James Norwood, one last chance, James Norwood!